Did it.
I want you to come up close, turn up the volume. We got a good show for you today. On today's SM Enlightenment, we're going to talk about spanking children. Do you believe in it? Do you spank your child? And actually, how old is too old for you to be hitting your kid if you do believe in that kind of crazy stuff? Anyway, and we also going to be speaking to Al Pizarro, okay, the organizer of the International Hip Hop Parade. And we're going to get into all of that good stuff, all with the hip-hop parade, what it entails. And, hey, this is the time for all you MCs. Come on out, because we're going to see who the king and queen of hip-hop really is. Also coming up on the show, a man robs a woman in his sleep. We got more talk about UFOs, another unexplained phenomenon. A woman rips off a man's testicles with her bare hands. Ah! The return of D'Angelo.
That's why you gotta spank your kids until they're old.
Hey, somebody didn't speak treat her right. Somebody did, maybe somebody spanked her too much and she had, anyway. Dimebag Trivia is coming up. We're going to get into all that good stuff. So listen, register to RadioScene.com. Get in the chat room. Okay, we're going to talk about some good stuff. We got a good show for you. You can call us 203-676-4848 because we're going to be discussing a whole lot of good stuff. So we got more on the way. Stick and stay. SM Enlightenment TV is on, baby. Coming right at you.
Put us on the board.
Come on.
Put us on the board.
It's new and exciting with live DJs, talk shows, and a booming online community. It's internet radio you can watch. Watch. RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
What up, it's DJ Santo. Be sure to tune in each and every Saturday, all right, to the Main Event Mix Show, 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. right here on RadioScene.com.
Get this dick, I'ma live this life in the fast lane.
What's going on out there? This is Sonya Blaze, straight from Brooklyn, NYC, representing. And y'all checking out RadioScene.com. It's radio you can watch.
It's your boy Salami with the Cheese. Make sure you check out the 10-speed and ground crew experience every Friday, 8:30 to 9:30. It's going down. RadioScene.com.
RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
Woo! you don't stop. One time and you don't stop, and you don't stop. Rock my horn, the Grand Wizard in the place to be. Got the great Doc P, Don J on the way. Huh, we got a good show for you, baby. We rocking the house tonight, you know. And once again, 203-676-4848. That is the number to call us, okay? Because we got a big discussion today, all right? All about whether or not you spank your children, whether or not you believe in spanking your children, okay? And we got some other really great topics coming up on the way. First of all, I just want to know how you feeling. How's the week feeling so far? Don J, how you doing? You doing
loving,
good?
Lovely, lovely, yeah? Lovely.
Yeah? Did you get your skis in over the weekend? Don J was saying, oh, over the weekend, he said, yeah, I'm getting ready to ski somebody.
You notice you didn't see him most of the weekend.
I'm getting ready to ski somebody.
If you notice you didn't see him most of the weekend.
Good too. I'm going to make sure she go to the package store before it closes. So what happened, man? He look at him. He's like, oh, you're blowing my spot up. Yeah, I know. How'd it go?
I gets mine, you know.
He gets his. He gets it.
You know, I guess.
Mr. Grand Wizard, you ready for a good show?
Of course.
Check it out. First things first, we're going to get into some entertainment news, baby. Yo, the very crazy Lindsay Lohan, that's all I can say. Let's look at Lindsay. Lindsay Lohan. Let's see the other picture of Lindsay Lohan. Lindsay Lohan. Woo! You know, I just want an excuse to show you Lindsay Lohan. I was looking at Lindsay.
Well, she was back in the news today, you know. You know she's back in the news today.
Yeah, I know, but I just want to look at her for a minute. Anyway, Lindsay Lohan crashed up her $100,000 Porsche in the beginning of the weekend on her way to a movie set. Okay, so she was driving a black Porsche on the Pacific Coast Highway in Santa Monica when it slammed into the back of an 18-wheeler around noonish. Okay, and the Porsche is just mangled. The Porsche is totaled. You know what I mean? You've been showing the picture. You showed the picture of the Porsche. The Porsche is just all kinds of messed up. And apparently she got into it also with the truck driver, all right, because the truck driver say that, you know, when she smashed up the car, that, you know, they was panicking and they had like a little bag of some substance and they ran off to throw it like in the woods somewhere, and that they was offering him money not to say nothing and keep it on the hush. So I don't know. She says it ain't true, but who knows? Who knows? You know what I mean? That Lindsay Lohan, man, she crazy, man. She party, yeah, baby, dude, come on out here and party with us. Come on out here, part Don J. He said, come on out, right, Don J?
I don't want her.
You don't want her?
I want the car.
You want the car? Well,
not
the
car, her.
The car ain't no more good. You see how the car look now? You show him how the car look. Show him how the car look. The car,
it's
man.
Still worth 50.
Man, the car is like in bad shape, brother. You know what I'm saying? Car's in bad shape. But anyways, you got the car. Look at the car now. Look at the car now.
Looks like Christine before the transformation.
Oh, Lindsay. I think she's still sniffing that stuff, man. I don't know. What are your thoughts? Hop on in the chat room. Let me know what your feelings are. Now, Grammy Award-winning singer Lauryn Hill, all right? One of my favorite Fugees. You know, she's also kind of wacky, too. But, you know, Lauryn Hill, she's been charged with failure to pay federal taxes. Okay, federal prosecutors say that Hill did not pay her taxes on more than $1.8 million that she earned over the course of 3 years. And she stayed out of the public eye for the most part, but has performed in recent months. She played to a sellout crowd in London. Okay, and this all comes from Yahoo
she has
News.
New boyfriend.
She got a new boyfriend? Who's the new boyfriend?
Nas.
Get out of here. Where'd you hear that?
Said. It's in the paper.
But she got them kids by Bob Marley, son.
She wants some more.
She knows Nas isn't paying any child support anyway, so hey.
Yeah. But yeah, but I'm just saying, Nas. So, she getting down like that? Did y'all hear about that? Talk to me in the chat room. Let me know what it is that you heard. What it is that you heard about that. You know, that's something. Now, I got a special treat for the ladies. Ladies, pay attention, ladies. I got a special treat for you. Ladies, check this out. D'Angelo is back, ladies. D'Angelo is back. Can we show him D'Angelo the way that they remember him? You remember that, ladies?
What the hell is that?
Yeah, that's D'Angelo.
Cyborg legs.
Yeah. Brother D'Angelo is back. A.K.A. Michael Eugene Archer. Perhaps is famous for flaunting his fabulously chiseled naked torso in that music video for Untitled. All right. And he's also famous for that last album that he had, Voodoo. But that's like 10, 12 years ago. But over the weekend, he was in fine form, looking good. You know what I'm saying? Rocking a black tank top, short dreadlocks, and a quiet smile. And, you know, he was doing his thing, you know. As you remember now, he was arrested. He was arrested just a couple of years ago, all right, for trying to pick up that undercover police officer.
Lonely. He was lonely.
That he thought was a hooker. See, that's how D'Angelo looked. See how he went from before and now, you know what I'm saying? But D'Angelo, he's on a comeback. He's on the comeback, see?
Why, did he join the gym?
That was great.
I don't know. He joined the gym. There's something. And because in that mugshot, you know what I'm saying?
What was the picture just before?
Yeah, that was him. That was the mugshot. You know what I'm saying? That was like,
no,
you know.
No, not that one. No.
Oh, you want to see the naked D'Angelo?
No, I'm saying, they were just showing that was his comeback picture. He was looking.
No, that's how he started out.
That's old. I'm not talking about that picture.
What? Which picture are you talking about?
Right there.
Yeah, that was him over the weekend. He was rocking out with the Roots.
He's looking at, who's he looking at, look at like that?
I don't know. He's seeing something.
I'm back.
Yay, that's what he's saying. He said, I'm back. I'm back.
And I didn't do my hair, but I'm chiseled.
That's right. And the next hook I get ain't going to be no cop. You know
You're
what I'm saying?
That's what he's saying.
So D'Angelo is back, and he's rocking the house, and he's doing his thing, you know? Now, in a topic that's very much related to what it is that we're going to be talking about in today's show, okay, Creflo Dollar got arrested, all right, for beating his daughter, all right?
And choking.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, yeah. And we got the Creflo pick. Yeah, see, he...
Tap out.
You know, he said that he was just spanking... said he was just spanking her. Said that she was being disrespectful. Immediately, you know, apparently she wanted to go out to a party, and he said you can't go. And you know, and he beat her ass. Pretty much is what he did. His wife called the cops on him, you know, said he was choking her and all kinds of craziness. And you know, it's crazy. So, you know, what I want to talk about is whether or not you believe in spanking your children. Do you believe that it's right to spank your children? Okay. And if you do, now, Creflo's daughter was 15 years old. You know what I'm saying? Now, after a certain point, when is it too old to be spanking your kid? You know what I mean? So
after they move out on their own.
Well, that's Stevie.
Up until then, hey.
That's Papa Stevie. That uncle, that's your Uncle Stevie right there talking.
Papa, don't preach.
Oh, man.
I'm
so
in trouble.
That's what we want to know. All right. Hop on in the chat room. Register with us right now. Okay, so that you can get in the chat room. All right. And a little bit later on, we're going to be taking your phone calls on all this at 203-676-4848. And we're going to talk about this. So, hey, we're gonna go to a little bit of a video. Commercial, actually, of something that I caught about what it is that you could do with those disrespectful bad kids. Instead of spanking them, instead of beating their ass, you know what I'm saying? You can get cash for your kids, okay? Cash for kids. So we're going to see that commercial, all right? We're going to go to that, and then when we come back, we're going to continue with more show. We're going to bring in the very, very lovely April freshness. And we're going to give a shout out to my main man, Al Pizarro, right? Organizer of the International Hip Hop Parade. We're going to talk to him about all that good stuff. All that and more coming up right after this. It's SM Enlightenment, baby. Stay tuned. Yeah.
$3,000. All I did was send in my youngest child, who's recently started talking back to me, to cashforkids.com.
Send in your broken and unwanted children today for cold hard cash. Send us the kids you no longer like or have any use for. Send us your fat kids, unathletic kids, whiny kids, lazy kids, tall kids, short kids, kids who like to climb trees, kids with low self-esteem, sexually active kids, kids with cold sores, greasy kids, kids with lint in their pockets, kids who don't go to the bathroom, freckly kids, theater kids, or any other kind of kid, and we'll send you cash from cashforkids.com.
I sent my grandson a lovely birthday present, and he didn't send me a thank you note. So I sent him to cashforkids.com. I had no idea my grandson was worth so much money.
Because of the economy, children, adolescents, and teens are at their highest value in decades. Cashforkids.com is able to get you top dollar for your unwanted, disrespectful children.
I was so excited when I found out we were having a little boy. But as he got older, I just realized I have nothing in common with this little stranger. He wasn't just gonna be a junior version of me. I didn't know what to do. Thanks, CashForKids.com.
CashForKids.com has recently stopped working with those North Korean pirates, effectively cutting out the middleman, and we pass those savings on to you.
I sent in the kid from my first marriage to CashForKids.com and got enough money to put my new kid through college.
Call the number below and ask for your prepaid insured child transportation box. Just fill the box with your unwanted child and send him or her to CashForKids.com today.
Please, Dad, let me out!
It's new and exciting with live DJs, talk shows, and a booming online community. It's internet radio you can watch. Watch. RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
What's up, everybody? It's Jordan Meyer, the One Man Band. You're watching RadioScene.com. It's radio you can watch.
Time is running and it's clear that it's over. I keep tripping, I'm in need of some closure.
This is Jim Slice from Flashback Fever. You're watching RadioScene.com. It's radio you can watch.
Radio Scene. RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
The Grand Wizard, baby. The Grand Wizard, baby. The Grand Wizard, baby. Yeah. SM Crew in full effect, y'all. It is SM Enlightenment TV. I am the great Doc P. My main man Don J is in the house.
Holla!
With his dolls and all that good stuff. You know, the Grand Wizard's on the wheels of steels. I gotta bring in the very, very lovely other addition. I meant to bring her in earlier. My bad, but I need my girl. I need my right hand girl.
I need you too. I need you too.
What's up, baby? April Freshness in the house. I meant to bring you in earlier. You know, I was just like talking about, you know, I was, you know, it was the Lindsay Lohan pictures. It's you know, because, you know.
That's what I'm all dressed for. I was hoping I was going to get in on the Lindsay action. I got my Lindsay Hollywood hood going on.
Yeah, I was
I'm ready.
Lindsay. You know, how us men are. You know, when you start to get a semi, you know, you can't think no more. You know what I mean?
Hi!
Well, how you doing, baby? You had a good week?
I'm good.
Yeah?
I'm not nearly as good as Lindsay Lohan. I'd like to be as good as Lindsay Lohan right now. I meant to make it to the liquor store before the show, and if I knew I wasn't going to get in on the first segment, I would have gone.
Well, I'm all right. That's my bad, but you're looking good, baby. You're looking good. Now, listen, I got this crazy, crazy story. I just want to tell you real quick before we go to Al Pizarro for the hip-hop parade. Yo.
Nice.
This crazy woman, all right, in North Carolina, police in Shelby, they say that they arrested a woman over the weekend after she squeezed a man's testicles out of his scrotum.
She's my new best friend.
Oh!
My new best friend. I'm going to give her a list with some addresses, and I'm just going to send her to some homes, I think. That's a feisty chick right there. That's a feisty bitch. Because most of the women that I know don't even want to crush a bug with a shoe. Forget grabbing a man's nuts and actually squeezing them out of the package. That's some serious shit right there. That's more zombie apocalypse for you. That's the female version of face eating right there.
She squeezed the man's testicles out of the scrotum. We got her picture. We got this picture of this woman. Her name is Joyce Maxine. Her name is Joyce Maxine Gregory. She's 35 years old. And she likes long walks on the beach. And squeezing men's testicles out of the scrotum.
Maybe that's the reaction that females have to the bath salts.
And she's obviously very available now, guys. She's a looker. Hey, you know, you want your nuts squeezed out of your scrotum? Go see her. You see?
Now,
Don J, you see her in the club, all right? You know what I'm saying? She ain't going to tell you. You're busy.
What happened to the nut alarm? You go near my nuts. I'm like,
you trying to find out? See, we trying to find out from last week's discussion how many guys she done slept with, how many partners you had. Meanwhile, she might only had just two. But when she get mad, woo-hoo-hoo!
He obviously was not very good.
That's
what should happen when you quit early.
Down.
You know what I'm saying?
No,
that's what the punishment should be.
Police say that Gregory got into an argument with an older man Saturday morning. When he went outside to call 911, she followed him and grabbed him by the scrotum.
Wow. That was a rough night right there. I think Lindsay was in the back. That's what Lindsay was driving away from. She was like, shit, I'm out.
Thin sack disease.
Just sickness. Hey, go on into the chat room. Let me know what you think about that. But anyways, listen, as we move forward, I got my main man, Al Pizarro, okay, that we need to get on the phone here. We want to talk about the International Hip Hop Parade.
And the history of hip hop, too.
Okay, and we need to get into the history of hip hop. Because, you know, we all love hip hop. And hip hop is the essence of who we all are.
At least on this show.
Right here. That's what it's all about. You know what I mean? But you know, what I want to get into is, you know, first of all, what is hip hop? Now I got my main man Al Pizarro. Brother Al, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
What's going on, brother?
What up, Al?
Al Pizarro, ladies and gentlemen.
Everything is good, right?
Yeah, man.
I've been all over the place.
Where you calling from today, Al? Where you located?
I'm located in the first place of hip-hop, the Boogie Down Bronx.
Bronx, New York.
Bronx, BX, baby.
Yeah. Now, Al has been very instrumental in the whole hip-hop culture.
From the beginning.
From the very beginning. Okay, record promoter, record pool director.
Extraordinaire.
Showed everybody across the country, across the world, how it's done as far as promoting music, you know. What I want to get into, Al, you know, I know, you know, you've been in the Bronx from the beginning, you know. Give us a little bit of history of hip-hop, like, just from your perspective, like, you know, you know, if you had to wrap it up in like a couple of sentences, like what is it? What is it to you? And where did it start? And how did it start?
You know what? What I could say is that a lot of the guys that were playing in the parks and playing in the blocks and all that stuff were playing different beats and all that, and you know, and the Cool Herc of the world and all that stuff really gave it some attention when he started playing it and playing at T Connections and places like that. him doing his house parties were famous. But, you know, you got Mean Gene, you got Red, you got Jazzy J, you got PTJ Jones. You got so many people from that era.
Right.
That the only place to play that was in the street. It wasn't in the club because it was not a type of music the clubs were accepting.
Yeah, and this is the 70s. This is before rap was on a record or anything like that, before it was on the radio. Like, the first place you heard it was in the park, you know, in the park and then in the clubs and all of that. So, you know, as we move forward now, you know, with the International Hip Hop Parade, I know that we're basically paying tribute and homage to the culture itself. Am I right?
Yeah, we have to be able to educate people and restore all the information, because this information is not kept. We don't have a hip hop Hall of Fame. You know, there's a Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, not a hip hop Hall of Fame. But yet hip hop is all over the world, has touched everybody, from everything from music, clothing to cars to lifestyle, everything. And yet it hasn't gotten the props that it should have. And now,
absolutely,
International Hip Hop Parade, that's gonna happen.
So what do we so what do we have planned for this parade? Like, is it a one-time event, or like how's it all entail, and how's it all gonna wrap up? I mean, I know, you know what I'm saying, but I just want you to explain it real quick for everybody.
Look, every single year we're gonna get together and we're gonna celebrate hip hop. But not only are we gonna celebrate hip hop, we're gonna find the best MCs in the world, male and female. So we're not just going and being gender gender happy and just saying, you know what, all the guys. No, females also, the best one in the world, and we're gonna crown the king and queen of hip hop. And the people who are gonna do the crowning are the people who started it off. You're talking about the Africa Bambaataa, the Cool Herc, the Grandmaster Flash, the Grandmaster Cast, the DJ Tony Touch, and the DJ Tony Tone, all these guys.
That's right. So we basically got, you know, a lot of the founders, the architects of the hip hop itself involved in this hip hop parade, correct?
The only way it will work. It doesn't make any sense to do a parade if you don't have the people who created the music, the founding fathers involved in it. But what kind of credibility would it have?
That's right. So now, how are we going to go about determining who's the king and queen of hip hop as far as with the MCs?
We're going to have competitions in every city, in every country. We just started building this up. And then these competitors are going to be online, and they're going to be able to see who's moving up in the ranks. Now, we get winners from each city, and then after we get the winners from all the cities, we're going to have a final to finalize who's the best in the world.
Wow. Now, that's hot. So you heard it here. What we're going to do with this parade is we're going to go to each city throughout the United States and see each state and see who the best is that's going to represent their state or their area. And then they're all going to come together to compete to be the king and the queen of hip hop. And then they're going to be they lead off the parade for that year.
That's right. They'll be with the Grand Marshal of the parade.
Now, nice. for those of you, we want you to go. Well, what is the site where everybody could go to find out more about the International Hip Hop Parade?
IHHparade.org. That's
IHHparade.org. And the phone number that they can call?
646-395-1114. 646-395-1114.
This is where you got to go to the website. This is how you're going to find out who your local reps are, all right? Call that phone number. Find out, you know, how it is that you could get involved. Now, all of you MCs out there, I know there's a lot of you that say that you're all this and that. I see out there in the Facebook, you know. Now, Stevie and myself, we are the Connecticut agents. And Al, you know, hey, I'm throwing it out there in my own state in Connecticut. I'm letting them know that as far as the king, who the king MC is in Connecticut, it's me. Okay? That's right. It's me. And I challenge any MC out there to come on out here and see if you better than me. And you know what I'm saying? Because I'm the king. So I'm giving every MC out here a challenge. Let me see what you got. All right. Let me see what you got. Go to the website. Okay. Are they able to register yet, Al?
The registration page should be up this week, but they could get their T-shirt. They could do a donation. They could check out everything that's going on the site. They could check out each state that's already involved. Go to their agents and everything. I mean, there's a lot to do. Be part of hip-hop. This is part of history. In the making. You're living it. Right now, you're talking it. And this is the first radio station to ever announce it.
RadioScene.com. That's right. You heard it first right here on SM Enlightenment TV. Brother Al, hey, man, it's been nothing but a pleasure having you, man, on the show. And, hey, you know, I want you to always tune in to us, man, because we always, you know, we represent in the International Hip Hop Parade. And, you know, as weeks to come, we're gonna interview with other people that are involved with it and talk to some of the other agents in some of the other cities and all that good stuff, man. So, hey, big peace to you, man. God bless you, and thank you so much. And anybody you want to shout out or say something to?
My partner in crime, DJ Tony Tone. I want to thank him so much for coming with me on this project, and of course all the agents and my family. And to all those people out there, you're not too small, you're not too big. This is the right time to shine.
Thank you so much. Al Pizarro, everybody. Al Pizarro. Alright, Al.
Alright,
Al. God bless you. Have a great night.
God bless you, brother. God bless you. April, you still there? April, where you at?
Yeah, I'm right here. I'm so excited about this. First of all, I can point at the Bronx for you right here. I'm pointing at the Bronx. It's right there. Yes. So this means a lot to me. I'm very excited about this. Yeah. And I like what he said about reclaiming hip-hop.
That's right.
And educating. That's so important, because I don't think that the young people out there, some of them really don't, I don't think that they know. Not that I'm a hip-hop historian, but there was a time when people did rap about things other than shoes and accessories and shooting people.
Yeah.
And not that music doesn't have some of the best beats and some of the best music. I mean, you play, you know, you put on that Beat the Pussy Up, but I'm going to dance. I'm not going to be mad at you. But there was a time when other things were said and other words were spoken, and that's important. That's very important. That's what makes it a real movement, and that's what makes it real culture and a real history. We have that. We have a significant cultural contribution, and that's what it's about.
That's what it is. That's what it is. So you know what we're going to do? I think we're going to bounce to a break, okay? And when we come back from the break, we're going to do some Dimebag trivia. Dimebag trivia. That's right. We going to give you a chance to win $10. 10 whole dollars. Okay?
Nice.
But you're going to have to be able to answer the trivia question that I'm getting ready to throw at you. Okay? So, hey, all that is coming up. We're going to give away some money.
You got the other $9?
Here's
the dollar that I'm donating to the trivia.
We have $1. We have $1. Do I get $2? Radio scene, man. You got another dollar. He got $2. Dante. Dante, you got $3.
My pockets are deep and my arms are short.
Come on, man. You ain't spending all that money on that girl over the weekend, did you? Okay, we got $3, y'all. All right? Hey, we collecting your money, so.
I can't get my hands out of my pocket.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? So stick around,
you
baby.
You can't get the whole bag yet, but you can get a couple of wraps.
Hey, you know, we gonna get you your dime bag money now. We gonna get you your dime bag. You gonna get your dime bag, okay?
So I got $3 in the light.
Hey!
You got a Western Union is up here, though.
Yeah, you know, you just got to teleport it. You got to teleport it. We're going to talk about Project Pegasus later, too. You know what I'm saying? The time machine and teleport and all that good stuff. Hey, stick around, baby. More SM Enlightenment TV coming up right after this. Don't go away.
Ban it.
I'm making it rain!
It's new and exciting with live DJs, talk shows, and a booming online community. It's internet radio you can watch. Watch. RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
What's going on, y'all? I'm the MVP, DJ Projo. Be sure to tune in to the Main Event Mix Show each and every Saturday afternoon from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. right here on RadioScene.com. Get this dick, I'ma live this life in the fast lane. Moving at the speed of life
and I can't slow down. This is Jim Slice from Flashback Fever. You're watching RadioScene.com. It's radio you can watch.
Radio Scene.
What's going on out there? This is Sonya Blade, straight from Brooklyn, NYC, representing. And y'all checking out RadioScene.com. It's radio you can watch.
RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
Yeah, we're negligent.
Huh. To the rhythm of the rock and you don't stop. To the rhythm of the rock and you don't stop. To the rhythm of the rock and you don't stop. And you don't stop at that physical rock. Doc P's in the place and I'm on the case. MC's in the place. Hide your face, cause I'm a repetition. I make people listen. Kick him off thrills and gain pole position. And fulfilling each and every need. All my other opposition. Peek to heed, the grand wizard is on the wheels of steel. Hop in the chat room and tell me what y'all feel. And you just don't stop. The rhythm has got to make your bot to bot to bot to bot to rock. Yeah, I'm not that good off of the skull, but you know when I rhyme, it can't be dull, cause I'm the great Doc P, the D from the O, from the C to the P, and none of you MCs in Connecticut can see me. I hear a lot of the cats rhyming.
Yeah.
A lot of the cats rhyming. I hear you rhyming with all of that nonsense, but you know what? You need substance, all right? Don't make me have to really rhyme for you. Don't make me have to. I might have to. I'm just saying. But listen, Dimebag Trivia. Here we go. All right. Now, big ups to everybody in the chat room right now. My main man, Dave Angel, KJ Jones.
Hey. Brother. David Angel. What's up? Love to David Angel. Big time.
Yeah. My main man, KJ Jones. We go way back. Way back to Greenberg. Way back to Greenberg, Stevie D. Straight out of White Plains. Absolutely.
Oh, nice.
Straight out of White Plains. Big ups to White Plains, Westchester. Stand up! The home, the birthplace of the original SM crew. That's right.
Big ups.
Yeah. Big ups to my main man,
that
Will
park,
Elliott.
Scary ass park.
Yeah. Yeah, Travis Park. Travis Hill Park.
I miss Scary Ass Park.
Travis Hill Park was everything, man. It's the first place where you kiss the girl. It's the first place where you drank a beer. It's the first place that you, you know, you did the nasty. It was the first place. That was the park, was the place, baby. But anyway.
That's the only park I've never seen during the day. I've only seen that park at night.
That's right. You saw the park
stop.
At night.
Oh gosh,
you know you saw the park at night. I was trying to bring you to the park and do some dirty things to you up at the park.
I was trying to let you.
I was trying. Never succeeded, though. But I tried. Anyway, Dimebag Trivia. Here is the trivia question, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so we've been talking about hip-hop, all right, and the beginning of hip-hop, and a lot of people say hip-hop started as early as 73, 74. Okay,
nice.
Well, you know, nobody really knows. Well, a lot of people have their theories, okay? But what I want to know, one thing that is documented, ladies and gentlemen, is the year of the first rap record, okay? Now, we can all debate which record is actually the first rap record, okay? Because we was really rhyming. As I heard Afrika Bambaataa say, we was rhyming since the beginning of time. We was always rapping, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But the first time when it was actually, yeah, the first recording when it was on a disc, okay? What year was that? Type it in, the first person that types that in.
is going to be our winner.
Rich. Rich. Get money.
1979 is correct.
Oh, that was quick.
KJ Jones, that's right. 1979, that was the year of Rapper's Delight.
Actually, King Tim the Third.
And I was getting to that, all Mr. Right. Grand Wizard.
All right.
King Tim the Third also was. Now, the thing about it, King Tim the Third came out earlier that year in 1979, as I remember. We was rocking a King Tim the Third. It was like in the springtime, I think it was, right? And Rapper's Delight actually came out later that year, around September-ish.
And it was actually, that King Tim the Third was actually off an album that had a couple of other songs too. That's that true. Was Fatback Band, and they featured Fatback King Tim the Third, Personality Jock.
Yeah.
Let me say this. I got Rapper's Delight
I don't think that was 1978. I think that was like 1980.
I think that was like 80.
Like that. Yeah.
That check was, your that facts, was, brother.
Square
I don't
Business
know.
Is the early 80s.
But hey, but you know, but if we got to go to the research department. Research department is going on the internet right now and researching it. And if the research department sees that, you know, that it's that you are correct, then I guess we'll have to split up the dime with KJ.
Pass it. Just pass it. Just roll it up and pass it. That's how you're going to split that up.
Yeah. Oh, gold. KJ. That was KJ that said that. Yeah. For, you know, KJ, remember the quartz. He's drinking the 40s, drinking the quartz. All that good stuff. But anyway.
According to Wikipedia, it was 1981.
1981! That was the Tina Marie record, okay? So there. All right. But hey, you're going to have a chance next week. KJ gets the $10. KJ gets the $10, you know what I mean? And, you know, we'll get it to you, KJ. You know, I got you, brother. You know, we got $3-$4 up so far. Hey, so in more weird news, now what I want to get at is the fact that in Iceland, okay, they got their own Loch Ness monster. There's a monster worm that's been swimming around out there in the lake, you know? And a lot of people, they got their theories of what this thing is, you know? The footage of the Iceland's answer to the Loch Ness monster, otherwise known as Lagerflot. 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 The river worm. There's a river worm slithering around through icy water, and he's been captured, you know, capturing everybody's attention there. So everybody want to know, what is the Lagerflot? Okay, hey, it could be the bookworm. Maybe it's the bookworm. It could be the bookworm. It could be the funky worm, the hustle crop worm. You see the hustle crop worm. It could be that worm, the funky worm. Or maybe it's Mr. Wiggles the worm. What do you think? You think it's Mr. Wiggles the worm, April?
Could be that's Mr. a big Wiggles. Worm. I think Mr. Wiggles, that would be Captain Wiggles, or I don't even know. That's a big ass worm. I don't even know why they're calling it a worm.
That's
I don't
what know why they're calling
it a serpent. That's a big ass really worm. Much more big name.
You want to see a big ass worm? Show him a big ass worm. Show him the big ass worm. That's the big ass worm right there.
Nobody in that studio better stand up. Nobody in that studio better stand up talking about showing the big worm. Y'all stay seated right now.
You don't even know. Yeah.
Playing with my principality.
Hey, don't challenge CBD. Don't challenge CBD.
This principality. I tell you, Smokey.
He'll do that in a minute. So, you know, going along with other unexplained phenomenon, you know, these aliens and UFOs, they all over the place. There's sightings all the time. How often is there a sighting?
Every 3 minutes.
Every nice. 3 minutes, there's a sighting. Now.
Nice. Wow.
Yeah. You know.
Not seeing. How much are we not seeing? That's when somebody looks up and catches it. What are we missing? 3 minutes, Don? Are you serious?
3 minutes.
And you know, and over there in Jerusalem, they had the UFO come over in Jerusalem and came down and, like, flashed some lights and took off, you know? And they got strange sounds going on. So, what
the
we going to...
swirls? You see the video with the swirls? The swirls are real freaky. Like, big fans in the sky, and they just turn into black holes and vanish.
Do you think we're alone in the universe, people? You know, tell me what you think. If you think we're alone, you know, let me know in the chat room, okay? Let me know. Let me know. You know, it's an interesting thing. And, you know, coming up in the weeks to come, we're going to also talk about this Project Pegasus, which is also related to the UFO stuff because, you know, this brother Andrew Bashago says that time travel is possible. Time travel has been around. The United States government been doing it since 1950s, okay? And it is possible to actually travel into the future, into the past.
And that we've traveled to Mars already.
And that we've already traveled to Mars. So that there's already, they've seen life on Mars, but it's in the fourth dimension, see? It's in the fourth dimension.
Yeah,
so.
That's a whole other aspect of the whole thing. There's the interdimensional beings and the interdimensional travel. They're talking about there could be 11 dimensions. 11 dimensions that you can't penetrate. You can't get to them. They can't get to us. But some folks can move back and forth. That's even scarier than the aliens. That's even bigger than the aliens, I think, than, you know, a physical being to have something that could just be in your space and not know it. Who's in the studio with you right now? Do you even know?
All I know is whoever's in any of those other dimensions better pay some rent. And they better pay their share.
Nobody gets a free rent, right?
Not in my house.
Nobody. So listen. So we're going to be talking about that a lot more in the weeks to come, all right? But what we need to do is we need to get into this discussion that we've been talking about, because as we was talking about Creflo with the spanking thing, and, you know, I've been asking folks to weigh in on this issue, you know? So what we're going to do, we're going to take another quick break. All right, and then when we come back to ride the show out, I want y'all to give us a call, 203-676-4848. Once again, 203-676-4848, because I want to know what you think about this. Do you believe in spanking your kids? Is it wrong? Is it discipline? Is it child abuse? What is your take on it? So, you know, give us a call, let us know, go in the chat room, and hey, we're going to bounce to another break real quick, and we're going to come back with more SM Enlightenment TV right after this, baby. Don't go nowhere.
Exciting with live DJs, talk shows, and a booming online community. It's internet radio you can watch. Watch. RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
What's up? This is Tressen Irby, 1/5 of the group Hot Five, and you're watching RadioScene.com. It's radio you can watch.
You're jamming to the hottest sound in the mix with RadioScene.com.
What's up, people? Every Friday, 8:30 to 9:30 on www.radioscene.com, the 10-speed and brown shoe experience. And I'll be brown shoe. And what I'm going to be doing? Rocking you. I'm cool and I'm just cool. You like that?
It's showtime. It's your boy Salami with the Cheese. Make sure you check out the 10-speed and ground shoe experience every Friday, 8:30 to 9:30. It's going down. RadioScene.com.
Hey, 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 there's what I'm doing. Juices up, Playboy. I'm cooling. I'm cooling. I'm cooling, cooling. I'm cooling, cooling. I'm just cooling.
RadioScene.com. RadioScene.com.
They're jiggling, baby.
Go ahead, baby.
They're jiggling, baby.
Go ahead, baby.
They're jiggling, baby.
Go ahead, baby.
Yeah.
They're jiggling, baby.
Huh. Woo, yeah. The Great Wizard Stevie Day on the wheels and steals SM Enlightenment in full effect, y'all. It is smcrew.com. Hey, make sure in Facebook that you join the SM Enlightenment page, okay? So getting into this topic, talking about whether or not people believe in spanking their children, you know, in honor of Father's Day, big ups to all the fathers. A lot of times the fathers are the ones who are the main disciplinarians, the ones that are enforcing the discipline. So, hey, the father's been representing, you know, on my Facebook page, my main man Alton, you know, he says that he has four children and he never spanked any of them. And he truly believes it is a form of discipline that was carried over from slavery, which is a very interesting point. Okay, but hey, my nephew, my homeboy, my nephew, Damien, you know, his reply to that on Facebook was that there is nothing wrong with spanking as a form of discipline, all right? Abuse is something else, he said. Choking your child is something else. Also, you can't wait until a child is a teenager to start either. So the father, even a pastor's first ministry or duty is to his family. And a man that doesn't handle his household well is worse than an unbeliever. Giving you that Christian perspective. Very good. Said he's all for starting a church and preaching and all that, but if your family is neglected as a result, you have done your family, especially your wife and children, an injustice. April, what's your take on this?
With the whole spank situation, with the Creflo specifically?
Well, spanking, I know that, you know, that you have some younger ones in the household there.
I really do, and they deserve to get smacked sometimes. I definitely believe in spanking. I don't think that you should spank a child in the face with a closed fist. You know, that's not spanking, you know what I mean? Wrapping your hands around their neck and shaking their head. That's not spanking either, but I like what the Puerto Ricans call a little pow-pow. I believe in the pow-pow. Like
pow-pow.
The Puerto Ricans say the pow-pow. You ever hear the, I love that. The little Spanish kids bugging out in the street, little Puerto Rican, and the parents are, you're going to get some pow-pow.
Like, and there's always something that they're guilty of that you don't know about, so a spanking any time is always required.
Pow-pow.
Stevie looked for an excuse to give the kids some pow-pow.
Yeah, I don't have any kids, but, you know, I got spanked all my life, and I was like, yeah, when I get older and I have kids,
yeah,
I'm going to spank, too. And I haven't had that opportunity, so.
Don J, did you get spanked?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Hanging on the bottom of the bed.
I on
oh racetrack.
Now, how old is too old, though, to be spanking your kids? You know, I mean,
when your kids are big enough to defend themselves?
Because you figure, now, you figure if you're going to continue to spank your kid until well into their tweens, into in their teens, then, you know, just a little slap on it is not going to do it anymore. You know what I'm saying? You're going to have to step it up. You got to step it up. You know, you got to work out, you know, and step it up. So yeah, by the time they're a teenager, maybe that's what it is. The only thing they're going to understand is when you choking them and punching them in the face. I mean,
yeah, you can't breastfeed them till they're 10.
You know what I'm saying? So I don't know. Creflo, maybe he's on to something there. You know, I mean, 15-year-old daughter. She want to go out. She disrespected him, talking back. Said what?
I heard that's not even his real name. Dollar is not his real name. I think that when your preacher has a stage name, you should be asking a lot of questions.
Creflo a lot of questions. Dollar. Just send us your money. You know, I think I'm going to be Doc P. Dollar from now on.
Yeah, exactly. April Dollar.
Yeah, Fresh Dollar. April Dollar. Don Dollar.
More Dollar.
Don Dollar.
Let's all change our names right now.
Stevie D. Dollar. There it is. Well, anyways, hey, we want your opinion on the whole thing. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, feel free to chime into the chat room. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, we enjoy you. We love you for listening and paying us some mind here on SM Enlightenment. You know what I mean? And, you know, this is a discussion that does not have to stop here. So, you know, next week's show, we can still continue to talk about this whole thing because it is something that's very, very pertinent, very relevant, you know. And of course, you know, we're going to always be talking about that international hip hop parade that brother Al Pizarro talked about. That's right. That's right. And all of you MCs out there, no matter what city it is that you're into, make sure that you go to the website, okay? You know, you got to register. If you think you're an MC, you got to register. I know in this state right here, in Connecticut, you know, I hear you MCs talking, but you know, whoever got the cojones, whoever got the balls, okay, to come on out, you know, make sure your balls didn't get squeezed. You know,
trying to get Dr. Pow Pow.
Yeah. You come on over here, and I'ma squeeze you and give you some pow pow on the mic, lyrically. I lyrically castrate
you. That's the sound the balls made when they squeezed out of his sack. There, it was like pew pew. It was the pow pow that she gave him. I'm sorry.
As a matter of fact, if you an MC, why don't you do this? Make a YouTube video and post it on the SM Enlightenment page. Make a Brilliant. YouTube video, post it to the SM Enlightenment page. Give me a little freestyle, all right?
Harlem better represent, because Harlem really should win.
Harlem, I don't know. Harlem could win. You know, the rep from Harlem, the Bronx, it could be the guy in San Francisco. You know, who knows? You know, all I know.
The guy cleaning the floors in this building.
Yeah, all I'm saying, I'm just bringing it back to Connecticut. Can't none of y'all see me, okay? So that's the challenge to you, okay? So come on up. Step on up. Let me see what it is that you got. And hey, we had a good time tonight, you know, talking about the worm. We still don't know what worm it was, you know. But we'll investigate that more and further. And we always going to be talking about the UFOs. We got a lot going on. We covered a lot. So we want to thank you for watching.
Don't forget, next week we're going to be dealing with paranormal. We're going to have ghost chasers in the house.
Uh-oh. You heard that, April?
That's scary and exciting.
My man Tony King from Extreme Paranormal will be in the house.
Nice. Hi.
And on this studio, let's see if there's any ghosts left over in that studio from shows past. Let's see who's there.
Ghosts. You know, I wonder if, like, when you're in the shower, if there's a ghost standing there watching you, you know. Or like, you know, when you're just enjoying some quality time, just loving yourself.
Well, we'll be able to document it.
When you're just loving yourself, you know, watching a good video and loving yourself, is there a ghost there watching you?
There's probably a cable channel on some alien planet out there called, like, Human Masturbation Channel. Just zaps it to all different people.
Isn't that succubus or whatever, the ghost that comes while you're sleeping and takes advantage
of
you?
No, that's called Xbox 360.
We're going to talk about all that and more next week. We want to thank everybody for watching, okay? April, I love you. Thank you.
I love you, Doc P. I love you so much. Good to see you, Stevie. Good to see you, Don.
Don J likes looking at you every time you come on the screen. Look at that grin he gets. Get that grin on his face.
I mean, that's good. I got one. It's Don. That's cool. I got one. I'm good with that.
It must be a lot hotter where she is than it is here.
Don say he want to give you some pow pow.
In the front.
pow, pow. I'm scared of you now.
Not in the back, in the front.
In the front? Oh, boy.
I'm going to beat it up.
Oh, man. So, hey, as always imparting, ladies and gentlemen, positive is the attitude. Positive is the attitude. We want you to do for self, be yourself, love yourself. If you love somebody, let them know, because we love you. Peace and blessings, y'all. Thanks for watching.
Moto play.
Exciting with live DJs, talk shows, and a booming online community. It's internet radio you can watch. Watch. RadioScene.com. 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 RadioScene.com.